be with the mic. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyi'ati a'malina. Man yahdihillah fala mudilla lah wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah. Amma ba'd, فقد قال الله تعالى من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة صدق الله العلي العظيم. Dearest respected brothers, sisters, elders and youngsters, today in our life the most sought after commodity in demand, what everyone is looking for, male, female, young, old, is one thing. And what is that? Happiness. Blissful life. Joyous life. And it's not just something that we're saying right now, but according to the stats, leading search engines, the most searched items today, if you according to recent surveys and so on, is how to be happy in our lives. And we know that what are the suicidal rates today? What are the youth thinking about? We're going to make that after the, before the khutbah starts. We're going to do that before the khutbah starts. So even the youth, what are they thinking about today? How many people are happy? How many women are happy? How many men are happy? How many youngsters are happy? How many elders are happy? And what's the medication for antidepressants? I had one friend in Danbury, Connecticut, and he was telling me how many children, the kid, he comes and he says, Sheikh, make sure you don't tell my father, you know, I went to the doctor because I'm not happy. I'm not happy and the doctor has given me these drugs, these medications to take. So subhanAllah, it's prevailing, it's going more and more and more. Now what should we do? What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell me and you? What's the guidance of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam upon this? But what should we do so that we can be happy not only in this life as well as in eternity forever and ever everlasting? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we know that is the only the Quran which is packed with all these perfect ingredients and recipes. تَنْزِيلٌ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. It can't be anywhere, it can't be in any other book except the Quran. Coming down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينَ. Who's bringing it down? جِبْرِيلْ أَمِينَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. Who is it coming down upon? عَلَى قَلْبِكَ. It's coming down upon the heart of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's coming, لِتُبَيَّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ. The Qur'an was revealed upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? So that he can show to the people, he can dictate to the people, he can show to the people through his actions, through his 24 hours daily life, through his 7 days in the week, through his months and years that he lived, he displayed Qur'an to us. تَرَكَنَا عَلَى مَحَجَّةٍ بَيْضَاءَ لَيْلُهَا كَنَهَارِهَا. He left us on a clean slate, it's night, it's visible as the day. You can see far. It's night is just like that. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave us everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوا وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. What Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is advising you to do, do it. And what Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is asking you to refrain from, you stay away from. And only my dear friends and elders, when we do this, then subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gift us with ideas, our lives, our family, our financial problems, all the problems will become happy, will become correct. And I'll give you one example. There was one at the time of Harun Rashid. Harun Rashid, he was a king. So one day he said, you know, I'm going to change my clothes and I'm going to wear the clothes of civilians, you know, regular people, And I'm going to go see what's happening in my city. I want to see what's happening in my... So he changes his clothes, he goes around, he sees an orchard of pomegranates, anar, rumman. So it was a hot day, you know, in Texas. I came from Quebec, from Montreal, it's -6 over there, mashallah, over here, sun shining. So he says, you know, it's hot today, there was a kid working there. He said, can you please give me a glass of pomegranate juice? Sure. The kid gets up and he squeezes 1, 2, 3 pomegranates and makes one glass of juice. So when he drinks it, he says, wow, this is amazing. Tastes so good. So now he tells the kid, oh kid, you know, it's a hot day, just one more. And before he tells him, when he's drinking the first glass of juice, he says to the kid, he thinks that in his own mind, he makes a decision, he was the king, and what does every government want? They want an increase in taxes. He says, look at how vast his orchard is, how many trees does he have, pomegranates, this person must be making good money. So what am I going to do when I go back to my chair? I'm going to increase taxes so that we can benefit. So after saying this to himself, he tells the kid, oh kid, can you please give me another glass of juice? Kid says, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pomegranates fill that same glass of juice now. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, اتَّقُوا فِرَاسَةَ الْمُؤْمِنِ فَإِنَّهُ يَنْظُرُ بِنُورِ اللَّهِ. Beware of the firasat, of the vision of a believer. That when he's packed with the recipes that Allah Ta'ala has given to us in the Quran, and when he lives according to the guidance of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then he is not he, she is not she, but they are walking with the support of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Ta'ala says, مَنْ عَادَانِي وَلِيًا فَقَدْ آذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ. The person who bothers my friend, what do? I declare war with that person. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُ. And no, you don't know the armies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِلَّهِ جُنُودُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. The armies of the heavens and the earth belong to one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't try to stand in front of Allah. Don't try to come in battle with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because everyone who comes in battle with Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wipes them out. So this youth, this nojawan, this youngster, he had Allah on his side. Today we are 40, 50, 60. We have been praying salat for so many X amount of years. We have done so many hajj and so many umrahs. I ask myself and I ask yourself, what is our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is our iman and is our Quran and is our a'mal giving us envision? Can we envision something? Can we see? لَا يُلْدَغُ الْمُؤْمِنُ مِنْ جُحْرٍ وَاحِدٍ مَرَّتَيْنِ. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a believer, he is never bit by the same snake twice. And how many of us have failed in so many of our businesses and so many of our ambitions and goals, we continuously go back to square one. Yes, there's a reason. There's a reason. And I'll continue after. So what happened here? This kid, when Harun Rashid tells him, can you please give me another glass of juice? 6 pomegranates fill one glass of juice, the second glass of juice. So Harun Rashid, he's puzzled. He says, hold on. Something doesn't make sense over here. First glass, 3. Second glass, 6. Oh kid, did you take the pomegranates from the same tree? From the same everything. So why is it that now, before 3 and now 6? So you know what the kid says? The kid, he has iman brimming in his eyes. He can see. Subhanallah. So he says, you know, in Urdu they say, Uncle Buran iman, you know? He said, you know, please don't mind, you know, but I have a feeling. I have a feeling. What's the feeling? The feeling is that we have a king. He must have changed his decision. He must have made some kind of intentions. Oh, he doesn't know who I am. He doesn't know. So he said, okay, toba, you know. Okay, now I'm not gonna do what I said. So now he says, kid, you know, he just wants to test the kid out now. And he says, you know, kid, it's very hot. I need a third glass, please, and I'm gone. Okay, 1, 2, 3. And it fills the same glass of juice. The kid, he stands up and he says, you know, something tells me that you are Harun Rashid. He's disguised. He's wearing civilian clothing. But a person of iman, a person who is happy in his life, a person who is packed with the recipes of Quran and Hadith, who has the orders of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his life, you can't hide from that person. You can't hide from that person. He can see, he's saying that you are Harun Rashid, even though it's not apparent in his eyes. Dearest brothers and elders, Iman and Amal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us so much. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us so much. All Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us is to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah ta'ala will solve all of our problems. Haya, man amila salihan, amal salih and iman, male or female, Allah ta'ala gives that person hayatan tayyiba, the best of life in this world as well as in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Hadith Qudsi, he told Musa alayhi salam, Allah ta'ala conversed with Musa alayhi salam, he said, O Musa, kun li kama urid, akun kama, akun laka, kama turid. He said, O Musa, you be for me, kun li kama urid, how I want. You be for me how I want. Akun, I will be laka, akun laka, kama turid, I will be for you how you want. We all want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to support us, to help us, to pass us in our exams, to get us those jobs. Oh, we have crisis. Oh, everyone goes through crisis. Everyone goes through problems. What's the solution? We just surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Hadith Qudsi, Yabna Adam, Anta turid wa ana urid. Anta turid wa ana urid. Wa la yakunu illa ma urid. فَإِنْ سَلِّمْتَ لِي فِي مَا أُرِيدُ كَفَيْتُكَ فِي مَا تُرِيدُ وَإِنْ لَمْ تُسَلِّمْ لِي فِي مَا أُرِيدُ أَتَعَدْتُكَ فِي مَا تُرِيدُ وَلَا يَكُونُ إِلَّا مَا أُرِيدُ. What does Allah Ta'ala say? O Ibn Adam, O son of Adam, you have an intention, you have a goal, you have a desire. أَنْتَ تُرِيدُ وَأَنَا أُرِيدُ, and I have decided from before. The game plan is, إِنْ سَلِّمْتَ لِي فِي مَا أُرِيدُ, if you subject your desire to my desire, to what I've decided from before, you do everything which I have told you in the Quran, what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has displayed to you and showed you. What will I do? كَفَيْتُكَ فِي مَا تُرِيدْ, I will become enough for you. And it is not, is it not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is giving us every single thing that we have, subhanallah? I mean, can we just count or try to count the blessings? وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُهَا. When everything is going good, everyone is happy. But when something turns sour, then everyone cries. And it's not just the regular, every single person. And then what do? When so-and-so doctor, when so-and-so surgeon, when so-and-so hospital, we take to the best of the best. And then when everything is at its terminal, the doctor says, you know, I can't do anything about it. Then you come to the Imam Sahib, Imam Sahib, you got to make some dua for me, please. You know, my son, my daughter, my wife, my this, my that. Allah Ta'ala says, why wait till the end? Why wait till the end? Come in the beginning, I will solve your problems. An average person, how much air do we breathe? 2 million liters of air every single day. I had a friend, he told me that in his country, South Africa, that his friend had to get flown from one state to another state or one country to another country. It was a flight of 2 hours of a duration. He needed 200,000 liters of air. It was a charge not for the transportation, just to buy that 200,000 liters of air, he had to pay $8,000. And how many liters of air do we breathe every day free of cost? فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. How many favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will we deny, will we put aside? How long is it going to be that we don't go back to Allah? When is it going to be that we go and submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Our hand, any square inch of your hand, any square inch of your hand has 9 feet of nerves. 9 feet, 6,000 nerve endings. One square inch, one of the most complex parts of the body. Just your hand. What if Allah ta'ala just makes something go wrong? Then our eyes, How many, we can distinguish up to 100,000, 100 billions colors. The information that our eyes can grasp is more complex and more detailed than all the telescopes put together. Our brain, I was talking to one brother this morning, he was telling me about how they surgically do things. I said, subhanAllah, We can't take care of our children. If we have so many 1,000 people, 2,000, 5,000 people in the masjid, the committee goes, oh, what's going to happen? How security? We get worried. 100 billion cells in our heads, in our brains, and every day 100 billion red cells more are given birth to. Who's doing this? One, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. Should we not reflect and go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When we die, the angel who's standing there, he says, يَبْنَ آدَمْ O son of Adam, خَرَجْتَ مِنَ التُّرَابِ وَعُدْتَ إِلَى التُّرَابِ خَرَجْتَ بِلَا ذَنْبٍ وَعُدْتَ وَكُلُّكَ ذُنُوبُ. O Ibn Adam, O son of Adam, you were made from dirt, a time is going to come back when you're going to go back to dirt. The only difference is that خَرَجْتَ بِلَا ذَنْبٍ وَعُدْتَ وَكُلُّكَ ذُنُوبُ. That when you were born sinless. And today when your body is going back 6 feet below the ground, you're nothing but sinful. Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, لِيَكُنْ جَرَاءَتُكَ عَلَى الْمَعَاصِي بِقَدْرِ صَبْرِكَ عَلَى النَّارِ. He said, let it be that you go on and continuously disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in proportion to how much you can bear with the fire of Jahannam. لِيَكُنْ جَرَاءَتُكَ جُرَأَتْ. Should you have jurat on this, the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, biqadri, in qadr, in proportion, sabrika ala nar, how much you are to bear with and have patience on the fire of Jahannam. Is it something that we can go through? So what does Allah ta'ala say? Fafirzu ilallah. Fafirzu ilallah. Go back to one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how easy is it? Yeah, how? Ya ibn Adam, law balagat dhunubaka anana as-sama' thumma astaghfartani faghafartu lak wa la ubali. Allah Ta'ala says, your sins pile up, and they fill the vastness of the skies. In this condition, you come to me and you ask me for forgiveness. Oh Ibn Adam, I am so Rahim, I am so Kareem, even in that situation, even in that point, I will forgive you. And I will never remind you about the sin that you have done. Oh Ibn Adam, you did that sin before, and now I forgave you, and now you're doing it again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, wa'adani rabbi, my Rabb has promised me. What has he promised me? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take out 80,000 people from Jahannam. And with each of these 80,000 people, another 80,000 people will be attached. Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, aw kama qal, Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, this is not enough. These people were still going to be left out. It's enough. But then he said, وَثَلَاثَ حَثَيَاتٍ مِّنْ حَثَيَاتِ رَبِّي. That how much more? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take out 3 handfuls from the handfuls of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't have hands. This is just to explain. وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ. That when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to forgive, Allah ta'ala says the entire universe and the galaxies and the 7 heavens and earth belong and come into the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to forgive, my dear respected brothers and sisters and elders and youngsters, there's no extent, there's no conditions, there's no prerequisites. Allah ta'ala will forgive, and Allah ta'ala will make the angels forget. Allah ta'ala, the square centimeter, the square feet, the square area that you're sitting on, or the sky has seen that sin happening. Whoever has witnessed that sin taking place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I will make everything erased from their memory that you have ever done that sin. So why do we not go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How do we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Very easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered, and Allah ta'ala has told us to stay away from. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us to do, and he has told us to stay away from. We do all that we're told to do, and we stay away from all that we are told to stay away from. And the greatest connection that we can have, dearest respected brothers and elders, is that we do a'mal. The biggest a'mal for the men, subhanallah, is that they start to pray their salat in the masjid. Not only for Jumu'ah, mashallah, I heard much about this place. It's mashallah for Fajr and for Isha. You have hundreds and hundreds of people. But we would like to see this entire crowd come. Not just the Fajr Musallis, not the 5, 6, 7, 10 rows that come for everyday salat. But we would like to see that the entire masjid gets full. And when we become pegs of the masjid, when we become people of the masjid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help will be with us. Secondly, we should preserve and we should stick to our Qur'an. The person who becomes the person of Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him rise on the day of judgment with the people of Quran. How hard is it to make the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while we're going to work, while we're coming back from work? Giving our children ta'aleem of Quran. Imam Ali rahimahullah, he said, لَيْسَ الْيَتِيمَ الَّذِي مَاتَ أَبَوَاهُ. Listen carefully, very stern. لَيْسَ الْيَتِيمَ الَّذِي مَاتَ أَبَوَاهُ إِنَّ الْيَتِيمَ يَتِيمُ الْعِلْمِ وَالْأَدَبِ. He said, orphan is not that child whose parents have passed away. إِنَّ الْيَتِيمَ يَتِيمُ الْعِلْمِ وَالْأَدَبِ. Yatim and orphan is that kid having the father and the mother in front of his eyes or her eyes. He is an orphan or she is an orphan. Why? Because the parents have not done effort to teach the Quran, the child Quran and manners and etiquette of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to quickly, because emotions are grown very quickly. Emotions and the want and the eagerness of making tawbah and going back to Allah is very quickly attained and very quickly dispersed. Right now we're sitting in these four walls. We're like, you know, I'm going to come for salat. I'm going to be good to my wife. The wife is saying, I'm going to be good to the husband. Parents are saying, I'm going to be good to my children. I'm going to start praying my salat. I've not done hajj. I'm going to go for hajj. I'm going to start doing A, B, C, D, E, F, T. And then when we exit the door, all of this goes away. So what do? We make pairs before we leave. We make a pair in that different places I have been. I have told everyone, make pairs. Keep a friend. If you don't come for Fajr, your friend should call you. It shouldn't be that, mashallah, you know, you pick up, you know, one person, one youth, he was told the harms of drugs. He read the harms of drugs. He said, from that day, I stopped reading. I gave up reading from that day. It shouldn't be that you choose a friend like that. No, you choose a strong friend. You come to the message for Fajr. He said, brother, you know, you look like a person who comes to Fajr all the time. Can you just call me? Everyone will make intention to this. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us. Now you can give the adhan for khutbah, inshallah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله الولي الحميد الذي بدأ الخلق من غير معين ونصير ودبر الخلق من غير عون وظهير وهو المبدئ المعيد أشهد أنه لا إله إلا هو وحده لا شريك له ولا نظير له ولا مثيل له وهو الواحد الوحيد وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله صاحب المعجزات الباهرة والآيات الظاهرة والفرقان المجيد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فيا أيها الناس إنما الحياة الدنيا لعب وله وزينة وتفاخر وتكاثر في الأموال والأولاد والأصبات والحفيد زين للناس حب الشهوات من النساء والبنين والقناطير المقنطرة من الذهب والفضة والخيل المسومة والأنعام والحرث واكتساب ما لا يعني ولا يفيد فإيانا ثم إيانا أن نغتر بها فنقع في ضلال البعيد أما نعلم أن الدنيا ليس لها قرار ولا لزينتها اعتبار فما هذا التغافل أما نعلم أن الدنيا غدارة مكارة
كم قتلت من قتيل وأهلكت من نبيل فما هذا التكاسل أما علمنا أنه قد وكل بنا عن شمالنا ويميننا ملك كاتب وشهيد ما نفعل من فعل ولا نتلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد أما قرأ سمعنا ما يأتي علينا يوم الوعيد وما أدرانا يوم الوعيد يوم همه شديد يوم يحضر فيه جهنم لها 70,000 زمام كل زمام يجره 70,000 ملك وندار علينا في كل الجوانب من غير بعيد فعند ذلك ترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد يوم يحاسب فيه على كل حقير وجليل ويناقش فيه كل شقي وسعيد يوم تقشعر فيه جلود الأنبياء وتتزلزل فيه أقدام الأصفياء والأتقياء وينادي كل نفس نفسي نفسي وتذهل المرضع الرضيع والوليد فالله عباد الله اتقوا الله فإنه أقرب إلينا من حبل الوليد واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا فمن شذ عن الجماعة شذ في القعر البعيد وحافظوا على الصلوات وحضور الجمع وجمع والجماعة وانتهوا عن المهلكات والموبقات ولا نضيع الأعمار المديد بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فقد قال الله عز وجل في كلامه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم اهدنا واهدي بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى واجعل آخرتنا خيرا من الأولى ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقيموا الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استو واستقيموا يرحمكم الله سووا صفوفكم فإن تسوية الصفوف من إقامة الصلاة. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. أأنتم أشد خلقا أم السماء بناها رفع سمكها فسواها وأغطش ليلها وأخرج ضحاها والأرض بعد ذلك دحاها أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها والجبال أرساها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم فإذا جاءت الطامة الكبرى يوم يتذكر الإنسان ما سعى وبرزت الجحيم لمن يرى فأما من طغى وآثر الحياة الدنيا فإن الجحيم هي المأوى وأما من خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس عن الهوى فإن الجنة هي المأوى يسألونك عن الساعة أيان مرساها فيما أنت من ذكراها إلى ربك منتهاها إنما أنت منذر من يخشاها كأنهم يوم يرونها لم يلبثوا إلا عشية أو ضحاها. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر كلا سوف تعلمون ثم كلا سوف تعلمون كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لترون الجحيم ثم لترونها عين اليقين ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم. الله أكبر.
سميع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Brothers and sisters, please hold on for a quick update on the ground situation in Philippines.